Hello student, in the last session you have discussed some of the application of a operational amplifier such as peak detector. In this session we will proceed and we will see the application of a operational amplifier as a comparator, which we will call as a zero detecting or zero detector, zero reference detector. In the diagram you can see here, the operational amplifier. For the non-inverting terminal we have connected the input, and for the inverting terminal normally connected to the ground, that means inverting terminal is at zero. So this zero detecting or zero detector will detect whenever my input crosses zero, whether it crosses from zero to positive side or it crosses from zero to negative side. When it crosses from zero to positive side, my output will be positive VSAT. When it crosses, my input crosses negative, then it will be, output will be negative VSAT. For example, when the input is zero, output is also zero. When the input is zero, you can see output is zero. But when the input is increases, then this becomes higher than this. That means output will be positive VSAT. When the input will goes in the negative direction, then this becomes normally becomes higher than this. That time input is a negative VSAT. So you will get either negative VSAT or positive VSAT depending on reference voltage, depending on zero. So this is called as zero crossing detector. So this is one of the application of the comparator. So moving on to next one. Before moving on to next one, you can see here the output of this one. So, zero detector, as I said, this is the output, zero detector. And this is our input. You can see this is our input. So, when the input is greater than zero, then my output is plus VSAT. When the input is goes in the negative direction, my output is a negative VSAT, which saturates negative. Once again, it saturates as a positive. Now, next concept in this one is, in the last concept, we saw, we compared input with the zero, that is, now inverting terminal is grounded. In this case, we are not comparing it with zero, we are comparing it with the known voltage. See, the known voltage is calculated by this voltage divider network. Now, so VCC is connected to the inverting input terminal through resistor R1 and through resistor R2. Now, what is the voltage at this point? Voltage at this point is according to the voltage divider bias divider rules. Voltage at this point is R2 divided by total resistance R1 plus R2 and VCC. This is the voltage. So this is the voltage. Let us call this term as B. That is nothing but B into VCC. This is a certain value. This is our reference. Whenever our input crosses this one, output will be saturated VSAT, positive VSAT. Otherwise, output will be saturated at negative VSAT. So we will see this one with the diagram. Here this is our reference. Reference means what we calculated, BVCC. This is our BVCC. When the input That is when the input is greater than this one. So this is the area. See, this is the area greater than reference. That time our output is positive. And this is the area the input is lesser than this one. Then that time our output is negative VSAT. And once again, you can see this is positive VSAT. So this is about a non-inverting comparator with the positive reference. So now next one is so non-inverting comparator. Now non-inverting comparator with the negative reference. Last time we gave positive reference. Now we are giving the negative reference. Now everything is same here, but only difference is it is V reference is B into minus VCC. B into minus VEE. Everything is same. This is now it is reference voltage is minus. That means negative reference voltage is minus. So how this works, we have to see how this works for this one. You can see here now. You can see, my dear students, this is our B V reference. B this one B V E E. So now you can see when our input goes above this one, output is positive. When it goes below this one, output is negative. Here you can see. This region is above V reference, negative V reference. That means output is positive. And here you can see here this is below this one. That means that time output is negative. Once again output is positive. So this is non-inverting comparator with the negative reference. Non-inverting comparator with the negative reference. So, my dear students, the next in this category is Windows comparator. Window comparator. So, window comparator is also called as a double-ended limit detector. It is also called as double-ended limit detector. Let me directly explain you the working procedure of this window comparator. So, this is the circuit diagram for window comparator. Here you can see we have two operational amplifier or two comparators. Here we have two comparators and two diodes, and this is the load resistance, and positive end of the first comparator is connected to something called as lower threshold point, and the negative end of the second comparator, that is inverting terminal, is connected to I threshold point, and we are giving our input to this point, now first we'll take now our V, this is our V in and this is our V out. This is our V in and this is our V out. Now I will take my input is somewhere here. It is less than LTP. My input. I will take this is somewhat 2 and this is LTP is 3 and this is 4 and LTP is 3 and this is 6 let be this is 6 and one more point I will take this is 7. So now the input is 2, that is means this is 2, our LTP is 3. Now which is greater? LTP is greater than V in, that means positive is greater than negative. That means this output is it will give VSAT positive output, and that will forward bias our diode, and our conduction conducts, our conduction path is something like this. So output saturated VSAT. So now my input is 7. Now I'll take my input is 7. My input is in this range. Now input is 7 and STP is UTP or STP, this is 6. Now once again you see 7 is greater than 6. That means positive is greater than negative. That means output is VSAT, that is forward bias diode, and it will conduct in this path. So in this case also output is VSAT. Now we will take our input is in between 4. So the next case is next case is, see, as I said earlier, this is, as I said earlier, this point is 2 and this point is 3 and this point is 6 and this point is somewhere 7. We have already seen this one now, and this point is 4. Our input is right now 4. So I'll give here 4. Input is 4, value 4. Now LTP is equal to 3. Now you tell me 3 is less than 4. That means output is minus VSAT, output is minus VSAT, that will not conduct the diode. So this diode is reverse bias. Reverse bias. Then what about UTP? So UTP is 6. UTP is 6. And UTP is greater than 4. That means here also negative is greater than positive. That means here also output is reverse bias and it will not conduct. That means during this period LTP and UTP output is 0. During this window period output is 0. Otherwise my output is 1. This is called as window comparator. So my dear students, with this we have completed some of the application of our operational amplifier or op amp. So in the next session we will see filters, how the operational amplifier can be used in low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter and other applications.